Beaches of Lake Victoria, buzzing with activities, fishing to be precise. Under the scorching sun, the fishermen bargain with those queuing up to buy, mainly women who hope to make a small profit at the local market. The verbal exchanges and interactions that take place here may look simplistic, but have serious ramifications in the financial and economic sector in Kenya. So vital are the fishing activities in this region that the government has envisioned economic development and social elevation of communities engaged in the fishing industry as described in its Vision 2030 policy document.
Nile bat is caught from Lake Victoria, taken to Kisumu. It is processed and packed for export. And when you export your goods, what do you expect in return? In return? Foreign exchange, okay? Number two, apart from that, our families, they are depending entirely on this resource. I see the area, food security. Our community is able to get enough food out of this lake. What is in the lake? Fish. Fish is caught from the lake. It is exchanged into money locally. It is converted into food locally. So our community depends entirely on this lake for food security, self-employment, and source of income.
Despite this flourish of business, lies some undertones, whispers of some invisible practice that has been in existence for more than three decades. The sex for fish practice, famously known as the Jaboya culture. Beaches of Nyanza region, the transaction between fishermen and female market sellers is rarely a financial one. The currency is sex, not money. Women selling their bodies in the hope of taking back a prize catch. The precise definition of Jaboya among the Luo tribe dialect means customer, a customer for some product, in this case, fish. The fishing practice in this region attracts mega businessmen and women from almost every corner of the country, but more particularly Nairobi. The bulk of the fish obtained from the lake is sold to these business holders at cheap prices. The women, who are primarily the local fish traders, are left in a catch-22 situation where they have to contend with each other for the remaining fish, of which, due to its scarcity, ends up being sold at exuberant prices, far much more than what the mega businessmen purchase them for. Those with limited purchasing power end up becoming prey to the fishermen.
Oh. ma ketimo rech e yie ka ji olworo uso rech to seche mego bei nyalo go bei matek to kae nigi kare tidhi ng'ado ne bei nikech en jaboya mowinjoruo samoro nyalo mako kod usipoko bende koro miyo bei michule kiwango pogore gi jok mamoko en inyalo duoko ne bei piny jomamoko gimiyo bei mamalo nitie sama rech onge to inyalo nene nikech samoro nyalo mi pesa moro matin ikonyorigo ka rech onge jaboya maisha mar ng'ato to yo monyalo konyogo to malich ahinya to kanen mana ni ka sama uradono to exchange dwaro mari need mari no konyoni mano kende.
Sex for fish has been commonly practiced mainly in low and middle income developing countries which have communities primarily trading in fish, with the most vulnerable victims being economically disadvantaged women, single or divorced women, as well as widows residing along the shores of inland fisheries centers.
En beach mar Kotieno. Wasebedo kwa loka iye ka. An kaka joma achiel kuom joma golo rech e yie. Ka gisegolo rech e yie, to gigolo oko to gimiyo jo ohala madhi oko. Koro kwa dhi e yie, to yie kaende en kama tich tek nikech ji laro rech kabisa. To kisedhi e yie kanyo, koro mondo iyud rech ma piyo piyo, kinyalo yudo mapiyo piyo. Chuno ni nyaka koro ing'e ng'at moro achiel kuom jogo kata minyalo wuoyo godo mondo koro iyud yor yudo rech no mapiyo piyo. Koro kisedhi e yie, siyudo ja iluongo ni jaboya.
Jaboya. Anyalo leri an gi chuora to abiro tie nam kata adhi yudo ng'at machielo moa luku kumachielo. To kaseyudo ng'ama oa kamachielo ni to yan amekswani atudora kode yor jaboya no atudora kode koro katudora kode to dhi nyisa ni adwari. Koro samudwara ni an mitiere kaka wadhi dwarore kode mwang'ire mwabed kamoro achiel. Samo bedo kamoro achiel ni odhi anam odhi lupo koselupo odhi biro to okawo rech moago nam mar gineno mar chiemo to biro godo oko kobiro godo to odhi luonga gi chien kucho ka chuoro kia kata chuora wan godo e nam ka to odhi nyisa ni bi kaw rech ni takaw rech kakaw rech mano chalo ka gima koro miya wan kode pamoja koro ka ang' osemiya rech to nitiere kaka ang' watiyo.
Kaka chule samoro onyisi ni bi wadagi. Ang' niwe mokidhi, dong' ang' nyaka idhi, ang' nyaka idhi nikech ibe in gi gombo, osechamo rech mang'eny, iwinjo ka dendi ochwakore moloyi, koro kosaloyi, dong' ichak achaka wuoth tede.
In Kenya, fish for sex has garnered particular attention largely because of exceptionally high prevalence of HIV around Lake Victoria. The growth of the Nile perch fisheries in the 1980s and 1990s paralleled the emergence of the HIV/AIDS epidemic. Research released by the Kenya Ministry of Health in 2013 suggested food insecurity, a culture of risk among fishers, prostitution, and fish for sex exchanges as some of the cause of the prevalence.
People in this business are many. And the people in this business
are young people.
And these young people, most of them are unmarried. And these young people, most of them have never moved away from the rig. They are 24/7 in the rig. Someone is 24/7 in the rig. And he is a human being who eats and sleeps. Don't you think he can be attempted at times?
HIV/AIDS in fishing communities has a breadth of enduring effects on fishers' livelihoods, fishing communities, and the fisheries themselves.
What do I do? You're a wala. I can just block on some more two in theater and I'm a kind. Masa Mori Gibedo get two. Two only on it here. Like any bread to Manakitimango, key year. To call key year to Kibido two. Could I not find a money, money, and I'm walking like any Yaboy Kenga Marat? Kaka, you're coming.
Fishermen are reported to migrate from beach to beach in search of the elusive catch, especially when it is off-season and fishing activities are out of their control. The female fish traders, on the other hand, remain on one beach, permanently awaiting the fishermen to come with their merchandise. Most of these women are widowed, single or divorced. They join fishmongering as a means of survival, and with increased poverty levels, more women migrate to the beaches. They have testified to have had sexual relationships with the fishermen in order to be sure of their daily catch. The national government, county governments within the region and the civil society have all weighed in on the issue and have come up with various ways to curb the practice.
Now what we are trying to do, we are trying to teach our officers the ways. If you have decided to do it, have your own partner. And if you don't have time, ask your employer to give you time to go and serve mama kwa nyumba. She also equally needs a service. Because I'm married to Joseph. I'm in the lake 24/7. Joseph has never seen me. Then Fred has come. Don't you think Fred will convince Joseph to talk other issues? So these people, we have told them to be given permission to go. And then other issues, we have told them they have to be screened to wajue hali yao.
Ending sex for fish for good requires a change of mindset for gender attitudes to be overturned. This initiative needs the continuous support and collaboration of the government, stakeholders, and local communities at large. Though challenging, this may be the only way to weed out a menace that has taken root in a society which strives to make a positive impact in the Kenyan socio-economic sector.